The National Youth Authority will be celebrating this year's 2020 event from the 12th to the 14th of August at the Alisa Hotel in Accra, where the First Lady will be in attendance. Nelson Osuansa, the Deputy CEO of the YEA, joins me in studio. Good afternoon, Nelson. How are you doing?
Good afternoon, very much. Good afternoon. It is NYA and not YEA.
The NYA.
National
yes.
Youth Authority.
Authority.
I understand. Can be confused.
And then with the Youth Employment Agency.
Yes,
pardon
yes,
me. Pardon
yes,
me.
Yes.
Thank you very much for that. So how is the NYA doing?
NYA is doing well. I mean, it's the pet body of young people in this country, but by law at 2016 at 939. That established authority. But the authority, I should say, has been in existence since 1974. Mm. And it used to be called, if you've heard about the National Youth Council,
mm-hmm.
that is the council that has metamorphosed into the authority now. So it is stronger now, and it has a stronger legal backing to undertake its core mandate of seeking the interests of the Ghanaian youth. I think that's the core.
Seeking the interests of the Ghanaian youth. It sounds great, but it sounds very broad. How are you able to about this?
I mean, we've been asked quite severally about how the operational remit is like. And I always tell people that we work from archaeology to zoology so far as the youth is concerned. So whatever that concerns this country, I'm sure it concerns the Ghanaian youth as well. And that is also our preoccupation. We are interested in the well-being of the Ghanaian students, the health of the Ghanaian youth, the jobs and the business of Ghanaian people, and so on and so forth. So you can go on and on and on and on. Every single issue, developmental issue, that affect the very fabric of the Ghanaian society, also in a way affect the Ghanaian youth as well. So you cannot distinguish between issues, exclusive issues of youth, and others of other categories or cohorts of the Ghanaian population. Almost every single youth here in Ghana is concerned about education. Is concerned about jobs, business, well-being, health, and so on.
Okay.
That is exactly what we do there.
Mm. So on next week, that's from the 12th to the 14th, that's next week, right?
That's tomorrow.
That's
tomorrow. That is on the 12th is tomorrow.
I don't know what's happening to me today, pardon me. So from the 12th to the 14th, we have a great program of activities lined up, I'm sure, to celebrate this momentous occasion.
Exactly. So we have, that is tomorrow.
Wednesday through to Friday.
Yeah, through to Friday. Actual day set aside by the United Nations for the commemoration of and recognition of young people across the globe is the 12th of August of every year. So every year, all member countries of the United Nations set aside this day to celebrate these young people. And I think it's important we highlight. Most often when we sit here or any other platform and we are talking young people, perhaps we'll be talking about deviance. We'll be talking about other antisocial behaviors of young people. But I think that the contributions of young people have not been recognized largely by the larger population. And it is high time we begin to highlight the contribution and the significant impact the young people are making in the country and across the world. I should say that if you look at the legal definition of a youth, which is 15 to 35 years, you and I would agree that these are the very critical population within our society. 15 years, they are very active in school throughout to their SHS, all the way through their the university, their national service. That's the time many young people are also looking at grabbing jobs and grabbing wives and husbands and looking for lucrative jobs. It's a very critical population. And we also say that that is the same category of population that is very exuberant. They have the energies, they have the fresh ideas, the new skills and technology, and they are the ones that are driving the economy. And that is why we think that we haven't really recognized the youth well. Unfortunately, it has always been about the deviant behaviors, the antisocial behaviors, and the youth are not listening and they are not obeying. I think we need to take the dialogue beyond this and be looking at the broader picture.
Which is why I'm sure the International Youth Day is
very significant. But we need to also use that same opportunity to recognize the challenges, one of which I've mentioned, that we are not including them well in terms of national discourse, national development discourse. If we are doing so, There's a saying, in Chinese saying, that people support what they help create. If we are bringing the youth on board in the discourse of national agenda, I can be so sure that if you now roll it out, there will be more embracing, there will be more challenged to make sure that that idea succeeds.
Okay. How do you think that we should bring about this this involvement, as you call it?
Yes. Fortunately, this year, the theme is suggesting that. The theme is simply saying that youth engagement for global action. So in effect, we're saying that if you want to take any global action in mitigating any problem, then you need to engage your young people. And we are starting and giving the platform this year to the young people to begin to dialogue on sensitive national issues. So beyond tomorrow, which is on the 12th, which will be graced by Her Excellency Mrs. Bawumia, we are on the 13th and 14th also setting aside periods for young people to dialogue on education. They are dialoguing on jobs and business. They are dialoguing on governance and elections, as well as in hospitality and entertainment.
Where are you gathering them from?
We have youth groups. Fortunately, the authority, we have been mandated by the law to recognize and register all youth groups across the country. So we have a compendium of youth groups that we work with, and we are falling on that compendium. Any other youth-based organization, youth-focused organization that is working in the arena of youth, we are also bringing them on board, and also pulling other young people from different other sectors to come and dialogue with the young people.
Where will this take place?
Aliza Hotel.
From the 12th to the 14th. So exactly. What do we expect to get out of the dialogue? After the dialogue, what happens
after
next?
The dialogue, that is a very important question, I should say, because after the dialogue, we don't want the issues raised to stay in the four walls of the conference room. We want to lift it up. Unfortunately, you know, this season is very critical season for all of us, because a lot of young people are waiting to hear from the politicians what they have for them in their manifestos. And okay. We haven't seen that. Okay. We want whatever dialogue decisions that will come out be factored into the manifestos of the political parties, as well as national policy. So we don't want you. So at the end of the day, we are coming out with a communique. And that communique is supposed to now help government to now begin to listen to young people, their views, their suggestions moving forward,
okay,
as well as the political parties factoring it into their manifestos moving into the 2021.
That's definitely something we want to look at. Nelson Osuansa, thank you so much for
it's a pleasure. It's a pleasure.
This afternoon, you're still live on The Pulse with me, Daniel Dazzi.